हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ जसवीर, योर इंग्लिश टीचर. टुडे आई एम हेयर विद माय फर्स्ट वीडियो बेस्ड ऑन द चैप्टर द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ अ लेडी बाय खुशवंत सिंह. दिस इज़ द वेरी फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर बुक हॉर्नबिल. एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू एन ओवरव्यू ऑफ द चैप्टर थ्रू दिस माइंड मैप, एज यू कैन सी हियर. सो वॉट डू वी हैव इन दिस माइंड मैप? द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इटसेल्फ, थीम्स टच्ड बाय द ऑथर, the story itself, three faces of friendship between grandmother and the narrator. So let's start with the name of the chapter, which is the portrait of a lady, and the name of the author is Khushwant Singh. Main themes are innocence, friendship, love, connection, kindness, selflessness, respect and acceptance. So these are the qualities of human relationship which have been depicted by the author very beautifully as main themes of the chapter. Students, it is a very touching story that shows a special bond and connection between a boy, who is Khushwant Singh, the author itself, and his grandmother. And he also lets us know about the changes which occur in their relationship as the time passes by. The friendship between grandmother and the narrator, it can be divided into three phases. Phase 1, when they were close friends in the village. Phase 2, when they both shifted to the city. Phase 3, when the bond of their friendship finally snapped, broken. So let's start with phase 1. So phase 1 started when they were living in the village and they were very close friends and it was the best time of their friendship. So in that village, the grandmother, she would wake the narrator up in the morning daily. She would wake him ready for school. She would accompany the narrator to the school. And the school, it was attached to a temple. The grandmother used to pray in the temple while the narrator studied in the school. So this is the first phase of their friendship. Now let's move to phase 2. Phase 2 started when they shifted to the city. So in the city, the narrator started going to the city school. It was an English medium school. Now the grandmother, she would no more accompany the narrator to his school. The reason was she started going to school by a motor bus. But still, both were sharing the same room and it was the common link of their friendship. In that city school, the grandmother, she hated English words, signs which were being taught at that English school, and also she hated the idea of teaching of music there. So this was the phase 2 of their friendship. Now let's move to phase 3, when the bond of their friendship snapped, when it broke. How did it happen? The narrator began to study in a university and now he was given a separate room. So this room, it was the common link of their friendship, and when the author was given his separate room, that common link, that bond of friendship, it was broken. The grandmother, she accepted her loneliness quietly. She didn't complain. Now she would sit in veranda, she would feed sparrows, do spinning and recite prayers. And this is how she would spend her day. When the narrator went abroad for higher studies, the grandmother, she went to the station to see the author off. There, she didn't show any emotions. She simply kissed his forehead silently and let him go away. The author here, he was thinking that it could have been the last contact between them. The last physical contact between them. And as he was thinking that the grandmother, who was very old, and perhaps he would not be able to see her again. But it didn't happen. The author, he returned from abroad after 5 years, and the grandmother, she went to the station again to receive him. As the author said, that his grandmother, she was not looking even a day older there. But that day, something unusual happened. That day, the grandmother didn't pray. She simply collected women from neighborhood. She kept on singing songs, beating drums till evening. And the next day, she fell ill. The doctor was called, and the doctor said that it was a mild fever and it would go. But the grandmother, she was thinking other way, and she declared that her end was near. And after this, she laid peacefully in bed. Means she died, she left the world. That day, sparrows didn't chirp. When the dead body of the grandmother, when it was kept on the ground, and the family members, they were making preparations for her cremation, the sparrows gathered over there, the sparrows which were her evening friends, they gathered there, but they didn't chirp. They didn't even eat breadcrumbs fed by the narrator's mother. They simply sat near the dead body, and when the dead body was carried away, they flew away quietly. So, thus, we can see how beautifully the author has depicted these qualities of human relationship, such as innocence, friendship, love, connection, kindness, selflessness, respect and acceptance as main themes of the story. So, this is all we have, and we can discuss through this mind map. And in my next video lecture, I will start explaining the chapter page by page. So, till that time, have a nice time. Be safe. Thank you.